Now, loading animation might seem simple, but it can add a touch of professionalism and flair to your website. Today, I'll walk you through the creation of a stunning line loading animation. It's eye-catching, it's dynamic, and it's sure to leave a lasting impression on your users. So grab your coding gears and let's make your website pop. Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to explain how to create a simple line animation using HTML and CSS. My name is Amara Chiugwu, and if you would love to explore more and more web design concepts, hit that subscribe button and let's get started. So I got this inspiration from app.skuda.com. So let's slow my network down so you can see the loading animation. So I'm going to refresh now. All right, so and this is what I've created. I have a simple structure here, a letter container that contains two other divs. The first div is a loader icon wrapper, which holds a loader icon where you can see the SVG, which is this care icon here. And the second is a loader, and inside it is a loader inner. So the loader is this line, this static line here, and the loader inner is this one that moves back and forth. So let's get right into the CSS. So here we'll have our loader container is displayed flex, and the flex direction is set to column. You know, by default, flex direction is set to row, and flex items are then placed alongside each other along the horizontal axis. But in our case, we want to stack one on top of another, so we have to make the flex direction to be column to achieve this look here. So align item center and justify content center. These two properties actually centers our flex items. So align item centers our flex item along the cross axis, while justify content centers our flex item along the main axis. So that's that for our loader container. And of course, the width is 100% of the body, and then the height here is set to the full height of the viewport, and also it's 5 pixels, so we just want to make it not be at the center of the picture, just to be a little bit higher. The loader icon, which is displayed flex and also justified center, this is just basically centering our loader icon. So for the loader, which is static right here, is positioned relative and overflow is hidden. So the reason for this is because the loader inner is positioned absolute, and during the animation, the loader inner overflows out of the loader. So we made it overflow hidden so that any overflow would be cut out and not be shown. For the loader inner, like we all know now, this is the line that goes back and forth. It's positioned absolute, so it stays inside the loader. And by default, it sets left to zero. And without this animation right here, it's just going to be at one place. So this is at position zero to the left. And with our animation, this what actually creates the magic that makes it have the back and forth movement. So animate is the animation name. The 1.7 seconds is the animation duration. The infinite is the animation iteration count. And the is in out is the animation timing function. So here we're using the animation name. We are going to use three keyframes to define our left property for the loader inner. So at 0%, we are setting left to minus 70 pixels. So we are basically overflowing minus 70 pixels. So the remaining part is just 30 pixels, which is what will be shown in our loader. Likewise, at 50%, we are setting left to 250 pixels. So we are basically pushing it 250 pixels towards the right. And we're also overflowing 70 pixels, leaving only 30 pixels to be shown in the loader. Likewise, in the 100%, we are turning it back to where it was at 0%. That means we are still setting left to minus 70 pixels, letting only 30 pixels to be shown in our loader. So that creates the back and forth movements that we have here. And there you have it, your very own line animation. How cool is that? Remember, you can customize the colors, tweak the animation speed, and make it uniquely yours. Play around with it and let your creativity shine. Let me know in the comments, what's your favorite loading animation, or have you customized one for your project? I do love to hear about it. So that's it for today's tutorial. If you enjoyed creating this awesome loading animation with me, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more content, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss an update. Thank you for watching.